Good afternoon. This is Sarah High reporting for Stand Firm. In the rush and hubbub of CO 56, the passage in the House of Bishops of the approval of same-sex blessings, I did want to highlight a few things that happened in the House of Deputies yesterday and today that are of a little more minor significance, but still are very interesting. There were three things that came up yesterday afternoon that we are still covering, at least part of this morning. First of all, there was the provincial acceptance of the covenant resolution. That resolution had essentially been substituted out for something far more vague and innocuous, as we want to be a part of the covenant process. And that was overwhelmingly approved, which is understandable because it doesn't really bind us to anything at all. And then there was DO12, that was support for legislation in the U.S. that prohibits discrimination based on gender identity. Gender identity is the choice that people make to identify with a particular gender and express that particular gender. Even if perhaps they are female, they wish to identify with the male gender or vice versa. At any rate, our church is on record as supporting any discrimination laws based on that particular segment of the population. But and then I would probably be remiss as a reporter not to note my own bishop. I didn't report on the House of Bishops actions yesterday. My compadre Matt Kennedy did that reporting. But Bishop Henderson is my own bishop. He's the bishop of Upper South Carolina. And I do need to note that he voted to approve CO56 and as well DO25, the two key resolutions that have kind of winded their way through the General Convention. I guess I shouldn't comment from a personal perspective on an update, but I'll at least take note of it that he is my bishop and that he voted, I assume, according to his own conscience. I do believe, and I'm not sure of these facts, I'll have to investigate a little further, but my understanding when I look at the list of those who voted yes on DO25 was that he was the only person who was a part of the former Windsor Bishops group who voted in favor of DO25, and I believe also that he was the only bishop who had been a part of that former Windsor Bishops group who also voted for CO56 yesterday. I'll have to check on that latter, especially because there may have been one other bishop who voted yes. On to probably the more important part of the day of yesterday that I covered, which was the joint session of the houses on the budget. Our presiding bishop opened with some very stark words about the financial scarcity that the Episcopal Church is experiencing. This morning, in fact, it was noted that the plunge in dioceses, the number of dioceses that have met their full asking, has been really immense between 2003 and 2008. I believe that plunge has gone from 55 to 33 dioceses met their asking last year in 08. I'll have to check on those numbers as well, but that was the approximate plunge. She wrote about how the cuts would feel, spoke about how the cuts would feel as if we are having a heart attack. They were so severe. And then she said very dramatically, death is reflected in this budget. And then went on to speak of resurrection. Of note, two other things about that debate. One speaker pointed out that virtually no short-term reserves were left. Typically, at the end of the triennium, they take anything that's left over and put that in the short-term reserves account for sudden expenses or new programs. Almost none are left now. And then also, oddly enough, in the questions session, a lot of questions were asked about the lawsuit funding. It looks as if $3 to $4 million is set aside for funding lawsuits in the Episcopal Church, and then there is a $1 million amount reserved for Title IV actions against bishops. And another question was asked, and I'll close on this. A deputy, Joan Gunderson, I believe it was, asked about the women's ministries line item being zeroed out. It was pointed out to her that the women's ministries were all being combined. And her response was, combined with what? I thought that was odd note as well. I'm curious to find out more about how the women's ministries, of which there are 13, have all been combined. Reporting for Stand Firm, have a good afternoon.